In the last lecture, we saw the generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal by using DSB-SC modulator. In this lecture, we will see what are the drawbacks of the generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal by using this DSB-SC modulator. For the generation of the SSB-SC modulating signal by using this DSB-SC modulator, input to the DSB-SC modulator was message signal or modulating signal MT, which is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT, and the carrier signal CT, which is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT. So, generated DSB-SC modulated signal ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. Although the generated signal for the DSB-SC modulator contains both upper and lower sidebands, but for the SSB-SC modulated signal, we only need either upper sideband or lower sideband. So, in order to generate SSB-SC modulated signal with either upper sideband or lower sideband, we need to pass this DSB-SC modulated signal through a bandpass filter. So, the block diagram for the generation of the SSB-SC modulating signal can be given by here, DSB-SC modulator generates DSB-SC modulated signal, which is given as the input to the bandpass filter to generate either upper sideband or lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal. And this bandpass filter will allow upper sideband from the DSB-SC modulated signal if the modulating signal is upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, and it will allow lower sideband from the DSB-SC modulated signal if the modulated signal is lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal. So it can be said that proper generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal from the DSB-SC modulated signal depends entirely on the accuracy of the bandpass filter. A bandpass filter allows the signal of certain frequency or a band of frequencies to pass through the filter as it is. The range of the accepted frequencies is called passband. The size or the range of the passband is called the bandwidth. With bandpass filter, anything higher or lower than this selected frequency range will be attenuated or rejected. This bandpass filter has two cutoff frequencies. First one is known as higher cutoff frequency, denoted as FC2, while other is known as lower cutoff frequency, denoted as FC1. Difference between these two cutoff frequencies, or FC2 minus FC1, is known as the bandwidth of the bandpass filter. After the cutoff frequencies, the roll-off of this bandpass filter is minus 20 dB per decade. This bandpass filter is very useful for removing unwanted noise from the desired signal. So, this bandpass filter has two edges at two cutoff frequencies and a center frequency. In the practical form, these edges are not that sharp, instead they are slightly tilted. And due to this, we cannot properly recover either of the sidebands from the DSB-SC modulated signal by using this bandpass filter. Let's see what happens when we try to recover either of the sidebands from the DSB-SC modulated signal by using this bandpass filter. DSB-SC modulated signal having both upper and lower sidebands can be shown as here. We use the bandpass filter for the recovery of the upper sideband and lower sideband signal from this DSB-SC modulated signal. When we try to recover only the upper sideband from this DSB-SC modulated signal, then a part of the lower sideband also gets selected due to the lack of sharpness in this bandpass filter. Similarly, when we try to recover the lower sideband only, then a part of upper sideband also gets selected. And due to this region, we cannot properly recover either of the sidebands. So, the recovery of the SSB-SC modulated signal from the DSB-SC modulated signal is not possible without having noise or without having a path of other sideband along with it, which is not desired. And in order to solve this problem, we need to make some changes in our message signal or modulating signal. Let's understand it graphically. In the earlier lecture, we saw that the message signal in the frequency domain contains both positive and negative part. What we need to do is that we need to separate this positive and negative part of the message signal. And in order to separate this positive and negative part of the message signal, we need to use guard band. So what's a guard band? A guard band is a narrow frequency range and it separates two ranges of wider frequency. So this basically creates a vacant space between the two radio frequency bands. This is used in order to avoid interference between the communication channels, which would result in decreased quality for both transmission. Now, Let's see what are the changes to the spectrum of the SSB-SC modulation when you use guard band in the message signal. This is the spectrum of the message signal having the frequency FM. And this is the spectrum of the message signal when the positive part and the negative part of the message signal is separated by a guard band. After the separation, the message signal positive frequency is from F1 to F2 and the message signal negative frequency is from minus F1 to minus F2. Now, when we take the DSB-SC modulation, then the carrier signal will be suppressed and the upper sideband and the lower sideband remains and they will be separated by guard band. So, due to this guard band, this DSB-SC modulated signal will have an upper sideband from FC plus F1 to FC plus F2 and a lower sideband from FC minus F2 to FC minus F1. The replicas of the upper sideband and the lower sideband will be created in the negative frequency also. Now, in order to generate upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, we need to pass this DSB-SC modulated signal through a bandpass filter, which only selects the upper sideband of the DSB-SC modulated signal. And when we do that, no part of the lower sideband DSB-SC modulated signal will be selected because of the guard band which separates upper and lower sideband by a narrow frequency range. Similarly, in order to generate lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, we need to pass this DSB-SC modulated signal through the bandpass filter, which only selects lower sideband of the DSB-SC modulated signal. Again, there will be no path of the upper sideband because of the guard band separation of the two sidebands. So basically, we can say that proper generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal from this DSB-SC modulated signal entirely depends on the selectivity of the bandpass filter. The bandpass filter selectivity is characterized by quality factor. The quality factor for the bandpass filter is the ratio of center frequency to the passband or the bandwidth of the bandpass filter. Here, the center frequency of the bandpass filter is F center and the bandwidth of this bandpass filter is the difference between the upper cutoff frequency and the lower cutoff frequency or FC2 minus FC1. So the quality factor, which is the ratio of center frequency to the bandwidth of the bandpass filter, is equal to F center divided by FC2 minus FC1. The bandpass filter with low quality factor means that it has wider bandwidth and the selectivity of this bandpass filter will be poor. And the bandpass filter with the high quality factor means that it has narrow bandwidth and selectivity of this filter will be high. So in order to generate SSB-SC modulated signal, we need to use bandpass filter with higher quality factor. Generally, the ideal range for the selection of the quality factor for the SSB-SC modulation is from 1200 to 2000. As the quality factor of the bandpass filter increases, it also increases the cost of the bandpass filter. So, when we try to increase the quality factor of the bandpass filter in order to achieve the accuracy of the SSB-SC modulation, the cost of modulation will also increase. That's why it is very difficult and costly to accurately generate SSB-SC modulated signal by using the DSB-SC modulator. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.